Hi, I'm ChaseAce5127 2.0, and I am the founder of the Baby Einstein community on YouTube. And if you would all like to have more information on the content that I post, please visit my channel, leave a like, and click the subscribe button to show your support. Enjoy the show. Hey there, YouTube, and as you no doubt have guessed, I am ChaseAce5127 2.0, and today I have a really special video for you all. It's a video that you all have requested me to do for quite some time now, and I never really got a chance to do it until this very moment. This video is going to be all about my top 28 Baby Einstein videos. This video is going to be my longest video to date, and that's because I'm going to go in intricate detail as to what my top 28 is and why. And before I begin, I would like to go over a few clarifications. The first thing is that the Baby Einstein Discovery Kit videos, the ones that have been released back in 2010, the newer, redone versions of Baby Einstein videos, they will not be on this list. The videos that will be covered will only be from the first edition. This list is also going to be very opinionated because, again, it's my top 28, and I can understand that some of you have other opinions as to what your top 28 videos actually are. And like I said before, I'm going to go in intricate detail as to what my top 28 is and why I chose it in that specific pattern. Anyway, with that out of the way, let's get started. Here we go. World music. World music is a video that shows all the different types of music that can be heard from around the world, as the title implies. But the problem that I have with it is that I don't think the music that is heard throughout the video has an accurate representation for each part of the world. The video even goes to Antarctica, and the reason behind that is something I can't explain. All they do for the music is just auto-tune some barking seals, and then this is the result that they get. The only good thing that I could say about the video is that it has some funny puppet shows, but nothing for the music overall. Baby's first sounds. Ugh, that's the first sound I hear in my head after watching this video for the first time. All this video does is take video and audio clips from past Baby Einstein videos and puts them into one. For example, Twinkle Twinkle Little Star from Baby Galileo, at least in different languages, and Humpty Dumpty from Language Nursery. This video lacks originality because the editors, I'm assuming, were too lazy to create new audio for the video, and it shows. Speaking of audio, the music also doesn't fit with the concept of the video at all. This video is still better than world music, however, because the sounds that are being presented still make babies self-aware of their own noises. World Animal Adventure. This is the fourth video in the Baby Einstein series that teaches babies about different animals, but it's also the last video to be released overall. I thought that having another animal learning video was too much because most of the animals that were seen in this one have already been featured in past videos. However, it does show some animals that haven't exactly been seen before. For example, snow monkeys, they're native to Asia, and iguanas, they're native to North America. The toys and puppet shows, in my opinion, are probably the best things that this video has to offer, but I think that's pretty much it for that. Discovering shapes. Like Baby's first sounds, the concept of this video is lacking some originality because it's almost exactly the same as another Baby Einstein video, which I'll talk more about later. This video teaches babies 5 different shapes: circle, oval, triangle, square, and rectangle. What the video does is introduce the shapes through puppetry. Next, they play a music video with that shape, and finally they reviewed the shape with another puppet show along with some drawings. In the end, all the shapes are reviewed once more, and then there is a final music video that shows all five of them together. Although, I do like how the puppet shows in this video introduce each of the five shapes. However, I can't get over the fact that there was another video that has already done that, and that's what ruins the video for me, in my opinion, because I don't want a duplicate. I want something new. Baby's first moves. In this video, babies are exposed to different types of movement, and they are divided into three different sections. We have first steps, let's play, and let's move. Every movement is depicted by puppet shows, toys, animal footage, and most importantly, actual babies. To me, it sounds like a no-brainer to include them in the video, but it's actually a smart idea because it helps show the babies that are watching the video how they could interact and know how they are moving. The only thing that I would change is the way some of the puppet shows introduce each movement, because I don't think all of them accurately portray what they are teaching. My first signs. My first signs is a video whose audience is mainly intended for children who have hearing problems or are deaf to some degree. Marley Matlin, an American actress and author who is deaf herself, guest stars and teaches younger viewers all the important signs through ASL, or American Sign Language. What I find interesting about this video is that Matlin is actually interacting with the otter puppet to review the signs that she taught at the time. Another thing that I like about the video is the music, because it sounds happy and playful throughout. The music is so catchy, and I think it has a lot of songs that children would really like to dance to. Overall, I believe that there's nothing more satisfying than learning a new form of communication, and that itself is a good first sign. Baby's favorite places. Once again, we are introduced by Marley Matlin as she begins to teach younger viewers in ASL the different places that many people would find in my street, the park, and Main Street. I really like the way the video is animated, especially when each place is introduced. However, when you mix animation with puppet shows, I feel like it needs to be done in a way in which the puppets are the main focus of the segment. Unfortunately, this video does not do that. Take for example the puppets eating at a picnic. The ants are not only stealing the picnic food, they're also stealing the show. I think that might be debatable because of the ants of the picnic cliche. The best part about the video for me is the music, because of how it actually feels like you're out and about enjoying the scenery all around you, and it fits with the purpose of the video. Baby Wordsworth. I used to watch this movie a lot when I was little, but as of this video, it's number 21 on my list because I don't feel like the music that plays throughout the video fits with the part of the house which it is initially heard. There's also something else about the music that for some reason gives me the chills. I can't really explain it, but that's the kind of feeling that I get out of it. This is also the first video in the Baby Einstein series in which Marley Matlin makes a guest appearance. Matlin gives more signs to objects in every room in the house, except for the bathroom, yet they show a scene with the mice cleaning themselves off in it. Honestly, that scene is probably my favorite one in this video, because I always thought it was the funniest, and I still think that to this day. I think this video still goes above the other two ASL videos that you saw, because this is the original one. Baby Monet. Okay, I'm finally at my top 20 so far. Baby Monet teaches babies all the four seasons and what they look like through the footage, the seasonal puppets, and Vivaldi's music. Speaking of Vivaldi, that's probably the biggest reason why this video barely made the top 20. It's not because of his music, it's because this video was supposed to be called Baby Vivaldi. I remember being a part of a Google Hangouts interview with Julie Clark herself, along with other BE enthusiasts back in 2016. Clark confirmed during that interview that Baby Vivaldi was supposed to be the seasonal movie, but they stopped filming because of complications between her and Disney. Anyway, my favorite part of Baby Monet is the summer clip you're looking at right now. Sumpert zebras, what do you know? Lullaby Time. When I initially watched Lullaby Time, I was thinking to myself, I'm surprised at the number of reused clips and songs that have been used. This video, like Baby's First Sounds, has taken clips from past Baby Einstein videos. However, the music choices is something that I agree with because I genuinely feel like the songs that have been played are relaxing and soothing to both big and little ears. Lullaby Time also adds some white noise, which I thought was a great idea, because when you're trying to sleep, I feel like some people need that one type of relaxation method to help them out. This video pulls that off beautifully, especially with the splashing waves. I thought to myself, that's something people actually do, and it works. If anyone who's watching this video is a parent, I definitely recommend Lullaby Time for your child, because trust me, this video will work. Baby Da Vinci. Baby Da Vinci is another one of those movies that I grew up watching as a kid, and I remember dancing and singing along to Head, Shoulders, Knees, and Toes because it was my favorite part of the movie at the time. Baby Da Vinci teaches babies all of the basic parts of the human body, from head to toe. This video stars Da Vinci and Mimi the monkeys, and they, along with some help from other puppets, show younger viewers where each part of the body is located. I also like how the video included an artist actually drawing each part of the body that is being taught. As of this video, that's probably my favorite part because the music that's being played is Well Hall by Thomas Morley, and it's satisfying to hear it play as the artist is drawing each part. Also, there is one part of the video where somebody's face is drawn. If somebody knows whose face that is, please leave a comment because I'm guessing that might be Julie Clark, but I'm not sure. Numbers Nursery. Numbers Nursery is about teaching babies how to count from 1 to 5. 1 to 10 if you're using the bonus features. Each number is represented by toys, stock footage, and puppet shows. I like how each number is introduced as well because there are little original stories written by Clark. And it's part of the reason why I do my own puppet shows as well, because I wanted to put in a storyline to make the video I post more interesting. Anyway, enough of that. Numbers Nursery has probably one of the best collection of puppet shows out of the Baby Einstein series, but the music that is played throughout sounds very repetitive because I feel like some of the songs are a little annoying after a while, like Trish Trash Polka. If it were up to me, the music choice is something I would change, and I would probably add more Bach and less Strauss in my opinion because I feel like that might be something that will work better. The orchestra. For somebody who likes to listen to music, I really like this video because its purpose is to teach children the instruments that you'd most likely find in an orchestral setting. There are five sections that are talked about in this video. There's brass, woodwinds, strings, percussion, and piano and guitar. I'm not sure why piano and guitar is included because they're not instruments that I'd imagine to be part of an orchestra. Anyway, I feel like Meet the Orchestra has some funny puppet shows, especially the one where the puppets are preparing to position everything in the beginning. Each of them are all flustered because they're in a hurry to get set up. I just think it's funny. The music, of course, is probably the best part because the songs are cleverly played by the instruments whose section has been taught at the time. Overall, this video is both visually and musically entertaining to watch, and I think this one is where children could dance to the music as well. Baby Noah. Baby Noah is the 16th video to be released in the Baby Einstein series, and it is the third video to teach children the different types of animals and where they can be found. I consider Baby Noah to be a spin-off to Baby Dolittle, and I like how they implement the Noah's Ark theme because in the Bible, Noah was asked by God to take two of every animal, one male, one female, to put in the ark in order to prepare for the 40-day flood. But enough about biblical facts. In the video, you get to see two of every animal being dropped off to their respective places of origin when it's over. After that happens, we are greeted by different animals behind animated doors. Overall, the puppet shows are my favorite part because I thought a lot of them were funny to some extent. On the go! This video is definitely going places because of all the different modes of transportation that we get to see. On the Go takes children on a fun-filled adventure by land, by water, and even in the air. I used to own this movie on DVD when I was little, and I would watch it almost every single day because I like listening to the music. This video has music from Mozart, Rossini, Beethoven, and even Smetana. On the Go also features original puppet shows and even some puppet performances with Wheels on the Bus and Bells on the Train in the DVD bonus features. And I loved watching each of them when I was little. Ooh, and a fun fact, I actually used this Automoblox toy car right here for an engineering CAD project I had back in high school, and I was thinking about this video the whole time when I was doing it. Baby Neptune. Water, water everywhere. Baby Neptune teaches babies all the different places to where water would most likely be. From the ocean, to the beach, to even in your own house. The majority of the music that is used was originally composed by Handel, mainly because his water music pieces were very appropriate for the video. Handel's music is the reason why I put this video at number 13, because I would either sing or dance along to it. When I was little, not now, of course. However, it eventually does get old to listen to after a while, but I put this video in a good spot on this list because it is another video I grew up watching, like I said. The toys and puppet shows are funny and educational, and I believe that they would also be amusing to see for any child who watches this video. Baby McDonald. Babies are exposed to what life on the farm is like in Baby McDonald. They take a ride on a tractor, a walk through the fields, and a big break during the harvest. This video also has a fun sing-along to Old McDonald to see what animals live on the farm. There are actually two different versions of that song. One in the video and one as a bonus feature for the DVDs. The bonus feature version of the song has a different cow puppet compared to the one that's in the final video. Dave Privett, one of the puppeteers for this movie, had actually made a request for a specific tailor-made puppet for the video. While I'm still talking about puppets, Baby McDonald, like Numbers Nursery, also has another one of the best set of puppet shows in one video. And that's why this video is number 12 on this list. Baby Galileo.
Look! Up in the sky! It's a bird! It's a plane! No! It's Baby Galileo!
Baby Galileo has really nice footage of what babies would normally see when they are looking up at the sky. For example, the sun, the clouds, stars, and the moon. Baby Galileo goes above and beyond that when it teaches all the planets, minus Pluto today, galaxies, and space in general. The music that plays through the video is like a roller coaster because there's music that's calm and relaxing, and then there's music that's jumpy and energetic. I feel like this movie is very cartoony, in my opinion, because there are a lot of different sound effects that are used to make this video. It doesn't matter to me because I'm a guy who likes his cartoons, and that's why it's number 11 on this list. Baby Einstein Language Nursery. This is the video that started it all back in 1997. Julie Clark had created the very first video of something that would go on to be an international phenomenon. According to Clark, Baby Einstein is not meant to teach foreign languages. It is meant to stimulate portions of a baby's brain that are largely ignored. The video is meant to stimulate the brain during a baby's first years of life. Baby Einstein has different languages heard, such as English, Spanish, French, German, etc. Overall, I feel like the video has visuals that would be satisfying for any child, and the languages that are used definitely expands the way babies hear people speak. For me, muy bien. Baby Newton. Baby Newton is the first video in the series that is all about shapes, according to the video cover. What Discovering Shapes did differently was just have different music and different puppets to show off the five shapes, which again are circle, square, oval, rectangle, and triangle. This is also the only video that includes 3D animation instead of 2D like most of the videos do. In this video, Isaac the Lion takes babies on an adventure to explore the different shapes that we would find in everyday life. We also get a sing-along to I Know My Shapes from Jack Moss. In 2004, Callie Moore sings that song. Overall, this is a really interesting video, to say the least, because of the puppet shows and the music that we get from Vivaldi as well.
Baby Beethoven's Symphony of Fun. This video exposes Beethoven's music in entertaining and fun ways through interactive toys and silly puppet shows. I did not watch this movie a lot growing up as a kid because I did not like Beethoven back then. But looking back at the video now, I believe Beethoven was one of the greatest and one of the most well-known classical composers in the world. This video gives babies a glimpse at his best works, from his first symphony to his ninth. The way his music is reorchestrated is also very phenomenal, and I really like how they pulled off every song that we hear in the video. Whenever I hear anybody playing or listening to Beethoven's music, this video is the first thing that comes to mind for me. However, I still think that there are a couple other composers that are better than Beethoven, and you will see why I think that very soon. Baby Dolittle Neighborhood Animals. Ah yes, the very first animal learning video in the Baby Einstein series. Neighborhood Animals helps babies learn all the different animals that they would most likely find nearby or in their own neighborhood, as the title of the video implies. The animal footage that is seen in the video shows what each one of them are like in their natural habitats. And also, it's a good way for children to realize how they behave and what these animals actually do. The majority of the music that's used in this video was originally written by composers like Nikolai Rimsky-Korsakov, Ludwig van Beethoven, and Antonio Vivaldi, but I believe this is number 7 on my list because I like how the puppet shows also incorporate different animal behaviors, and I used to watch and mimic each one of them when I was little because I thought they were funny to see them behave the way they did. Baby Dolittle World Animals. I love World Animals for its music, puppet shows, toys, everything. I would almost consider this to be the perfect Baby Einstein video, if it hadn't cut out the fourth section, that is. However, what I like about this video the most out of the three I just said would be the music, because it makes you want to get up and dance and sing. I know I did when I watched this video for the first time as a kid. Speaking of singing, this video has another Jack Moss original song called Swimming in the Deep Blue Sea, and it's probably one of the best original songs that has ever been in any Baby Einstein video. Another favorite part of World Animals that I like is the giraffe cone puppet, because I like how funny it looks and how it makes funny noises as well. Like right here, there's a drum roll. Yeah, something like that. Baby Santa's Music Box. I love the holidays. Christmas is and always will be my favorite time of the year because I get to spend time with my family, and it makes me feel really happy just thinking about the fun times I have with them. This video gives babies the holiday spirit that they need by puppet shows, classical music, Christmas decorations, and most importantly, Christmas carols. My favorite of the carols that have been heard in this video has to be 12 Days of Christmas, because it has a Caribbean style to it since it's played through steel drums. There's also some fun activities that can be done that this video shows as well. For example, gingerbread cookie making, gingerbread house building, tree decorating, and more. This video is definitely one that will get any baby into the holiday spirit. Baby Bach. Johann Sebastian Bach is one of the oldest classical composers whose music has been used in any Baby Einstein video. However, this video's music has nothing but Bach, and that's why it's number 4 on this list. The song that you're listening to right now is my favorite in the whole video, and this song is called Brandenburg Concerto No. 2 BWV 1047 3rd Movement. Oh boy, that's a mouthful. The toys along with the music in Baby Bach are really intriguing visuals used to enhance any baby's brain capacity. This video is good for any parent who wants their children to be exposed to music that will help them focus later on in life. To this day,
I even still listen to classical music while I'm doing homework, studying for a test, and sometimes just relaxing in general. This is another video I definitely recommend for any parent. Baby Shakespeare. Baby Shakespeare introduces the art of language and poetry to your child. This video also includes 12 different vocabulary words with individual poems per word. To name a few, the video has words like flower, butterfly, snow, etc. Baby Shakespeare also has music videos that have some of Beethoven's classic pieces like what you're listening to right now, Rage for a Lost Penny. The toys in the music videos are unique in their own way because they would either dance to the songs that are being played or they would just run away from one another. I really like this video, especially because Bard the Dragon is the main puppet for the video, and I grew up having a Bard puppet of my very own, but there's still two other videos that I think are just a little bit better than this one, and I'll explain why. Baby Van Gogh. From the palette to the screen, Baby Van Gogh is a masterpiece both through the music and the colors as intended. This video goes over the six colors in Rojibip in all sorts of funny ways. Baby Van Gogh is one of a kind because the music that's been reorchestrated is rarely used in other Baby Einstein videos. The music was originally from composers like Eric Satie, Gioachino Rossini, Maurice Ravel, Mattis Mazursky, etc. When the puppets dance along to the music, that's what's bringing this video to the number 2 spot. Another reason for that is the colorful paintings and toy music videos that are shown throughout the video. If I had the ability, I would ask every parent out there to go buy this video for their child right now, because I watched it a lot when I was little, and it still lives up to its expectations to this very day. And now, for the moment of truth. Baby Mozart! From the minute I watched this video for the first time, I thought right away it'd be something I would remember for the rest of my life. Baby Mozart has everything from intriguing toys, great new orchestrations, and who could forget the most iconic puppet show of the entire Baby Einstein series, Bards. Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart is my favorite classical composer of all time. It's unfortunate for me to think about the fact that he died at a young age. As a kid, if I would choose any Baby Einstein video to watch, this video would always be my first choice. Baby Mozart has some iconic toys as well, like Tri-Illusion, the Bard puppet as I mentioned before, the Mini Orbiter, and many more. This is also the video that made me want to own the toys that we're seeing here. I used to own the Castle Pounder toy when I was little, but I got rid of it because I was losing the colorful plastic balls. As of this video, most of the toys that I do own were originally seen in this video. Baby Mozart really meant a lot to me, and I really hope parents will give their children the same opportunity. Alright everybody, that is the end of my top 28 list, and if you all enjoyed what you saw, you can leave a like, a comment, and you could also click the subscribe button on the screen there to show your support. It'd be most appreciated. Before I go, I would like to give an extra special thanks to BayBVGo 2.0 for allowing me to use his wonderful song remixes for each of the Baby Einstein movies I've shown to you today. He makes wonderful garage band remixes of many Baby Einstein songs and many other classical pieces as well. I believe this person needs a lot more recognition to what he already has, and he could really use your help as well. So his channel info will be in the description, and you can also click the subscribe button on the screen right now as well. It'd be most appreciated. I cannot stress enough how well-sounded and accurate his videos actually are. They're fantastic. He could really use your support. Until then, everybody, I will see you all in my next video.